There are three different physics modes that an object can have in hyperPad. They control how an object can interact with another object by physical means. Collisions plays a huge role in this, and knowing all of these physics modes will be necessary for someone to make a decent project in hyperPad. There are three different physics modes: wall, scenery, and physics. Wall objects are stationary and won't react to physical forces, like when something hits it or if another object is pushing against it.
It won't budge a bit,
unless you tell it to.
Physics objects are not always stationary, as they can react to physical forces like gravity and air resistance. These forces can be controlled by behaviors. There's a global setting for adjusting gravity. They can physically interact with wall objects or other physics objects. If you have used a more advanced program than HyperPad to make games or render scenes, then you know that setting an object in HyperPad as a wall or a physics object is like applying a rigid body. In fact, HyperPad utilizes rigid bodies for walls and physics objects as they use the CHIPMUNK 2D physics engine. Fun fact! HyperPad actually used to utilize the Box 2D engine to serve physics functionality. The developers decided to migrate to CHIPMUNK 2D because it is significantly faster in terms of runtime performance. I can go into more detail about this type of stuff, but that will be in an upcoming video. Yup, I just know too much about HyperPad! Huh, why did they hire me as ambassador again? I forgot. Anyways,
what the frick's a rigid body? Why did you bring it up, RX? Why?
Good question. Well, a rigid body is just an object whose shape never deforms. In other words, its collision does not change. Ever. Unless you wanted to. Yeah, you can change the collision of an object by pressing this button. Cool. But you get the point. A rigid body is not squishy, and parts of it will not break off if you shoot it with bullets or something like that. Its shape generally never changes. Some people might not care about this, and I understand, but this is useful to know because now you know that your objects will remain in the same shape and size no matter how much you push them around. So, what do we know so far? While objects are always stationary, physics objects are not always stationary and can react to physical forces. Wall objects and physics objects are both rigid bodies. Okay, here's where people get confused. Since wall objects and physics objects are both rigid bodies, they work with the collide behavior. That means that it can detect collision. A wall object can collide with another wall object and trigger the collide behavior, even if it doesn't seem like moving them together actually does anything. And of course, you can have any combination of wall and physics objects colliding together to trigger this behavior. Oh right, and because they are rigid bodies, there's a toggle for them to be passable. When an object is passable, it can pass all objects and ignore physical collision. But that doesn't mean it won't trigger the collide behavior. Passable only means that an object can ignore another object's physical collision. It's like a fart. It's passable, but you can feel the effects of it. If you notice that your player is falling to the ground or is somehow clipping through objects that you're not supposed to, it's probably because one of those objects are passable. Now, there's one more physics mode that I have not touched on yet, and that's scenery. Scenery objects do not have a rigid body, so they cannot physically interact with other objects. The collide behavior will not work on them. They are stationary, just like wall objects, and they're always passable no matter what. And you're probably thinking, why do we need scenery objects? They're just wall objects that are always passable and they have no collision? Why? Well, let me tell you why. Scenery objects are actually pretty useful. If it isn't obvious enough, you would use scenery objects for objects in a scene. The player will be able to walk through them, no problem. The advantage that scenery objects have over wall objects is that they are very light on performance. Because they don't have rigid bodies and therefore no physics, less computing resources are spent on managing scenery objects than wall objects.
Muy bien.
So you can fill your scene with hundreds of scenery objects without worrying about the lag that comes with rigid bodies. And one more thing, When you pause your project, you can enable object boundaries and see the collisions of every single object. Scenery objects obviously don't have one, but wall objects and physics objects do. They are represented by different colors. This is useful for seeing how your objects are physically interacting with each other. Cool, right?
Till it's cool, just cool, into the mouth. Nice.
And that's all you need to know about the three physics modes. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this simple little tutorial. Please comment down below what you want to learn next, and I will see you next time.
Bye!